Still daily driving this little beast. Although I gotta say, I can't wait until it's all-wheel drive, Subaru powered, reliable, twice the power probably. All right, it's gonna be. It's gonna be so sweet. Yeah, it's gonna be really awesome. And that is going to start after we're done with the RX-7. So, RX-7 all-wheel drive swap rally Miata, because I gotta say, I really do miss working on the rally Miata. And it's gonna be such a beast once it's finished. I gotta be 100% honest with you guys. I have been seriously debating on selling the RX-7. Just saying, screw it, we're not gonna do this engine swap and just selling it. Because here's the thing, the RX-7, well, for number one, it's a drift car, all right? Everybody on YouTube has a drift car now. Everyone has it, it's not that entertaining anymore. This build series with the RX-7 has never really done great on my channel. Like, it does okay, but it definitely doesn't get a ton of views. So I was like, why am I gonna put all this money into a car that, you know, isn't gonna do amazing on the channel, and, you know, stuff like that. And I know it's not all about the views, but YouTube is still my job, and I do have to keep in mind that, you know, I gotta spend money on things that will actually do well. But then I was like, wait a second. Well, let's take a step back here, all right? If I sell this car before I finish the engine swap, I am 100% going to regret it. For the rest of my life, I'm gonna be like, damn it, should have done that engine swap on that RX-7. And I'll miss it, and it'll just be a sad day, so I'm still gonna do the engine swap. I have to. I'm gonna force myself to do it, no matter how much, like, the thing is, it's just been sitting for so long. It's dirty, it's sitting, it's just kind of sad looking, so I'm like, why am I gonna spend, like, $5,000-$6,000 on this car? But I gotta, because I promise you, the moment I get that engine in there running and I turn it on for the first time, I'm gonna be the happiest man alive, just for a split second. So we are still doing the engine swap. I do need more money to do it though, so I'm gonna sell the old engine. I was originally gonna use the old engine for a new plan for like another build in the future, but we gotta focus on the here and now. So I'm gonna sell the engine. So if you guys are looking for a running S5 NA13B with the engine, the trans, the wiring harness, the ECU, and everything else you need to swap it into your car, hit me up on email. I think most of the NA motors with the full swap are going for around $1,000, so I'm gonna ask for around $1,000. So if you guys are interested, hit me up. Also, if you want to buy a t-shirt and help this thing go down, that'd be awesome. I also want to say thank you to everybody who has bought a t-shirt. I'm actually wearing a Gingium t-shirt under this, so I would show you, but I'm cold, so I'm not going to take it off. Anyway, today we're going to be working on the Adventure Bus yet again. We're doing curtain install. Pretty much what we're going to do is we're going to install this curtain rod. It's a cool, like, industrial looking curtain rod, which is exactly what I was going for. We're going to install this curtain rod above the windows and then put the curtains on it. And call it there. They work perfectly. Are they the prettiest curtains? No. Guess how much they were? They were like $5 on Amazon, but it works. I can't say I'm really surprised. These aren't as long as they were supposed to be. See, like, even stretched out, they don't cover the window. this is why you don't buy cheap stuff off Amazon, guys. Also, don't buy expensive stuff off Amazon. But yeah, like, I love Amazon, so I can't, can I really hate? I don't know. But, you know, they'll do the job for now. They cover the windows mostly. It's not perfect. The curtains are up. Now, as you can see, this one right here, way too long. And as you can see, these ones right here, a little bit too short. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna switch them around, put these two short ones right here, and put this one long one over here, order another long one, and then hem them up. And that should look a little better. The curtains work. It's dark in here. They work pretty well. And that's much better. Much, much better. These still aren't wide enough either, so we're gonna have to get a new one of these. But yeah. Took the futon out because we're gonna be building the table right here. So we installed those little guys so that while we're driving, we want the curtains open, they're not going to move around. And as you can see, they have them restrained, so they can't move around. They still move around a little bit, and they make some noise while driving around, or at least I'm sure they will, but that's okay. At least they're not going to fly all over the place now, so that's pretty good. That's it. That's the finished product. That's how you install curtains in a mini school bus. I wasn't exactly happy with them at first, but now that they're in here a little bit longer, I'm pretty happy with them. We definitely need to get longer ones for these so they actually take up the entire thing. But besides that and the lack of curtains for right there, they're awesome. They block out a lot of the light. They add some privacy in here. We need some down here as well, but those will be later on. And they kind of hide the ugly windows and stuff, so when they're closed, the bus feels a little bit homier, and it's really nice. It matches with the walls and the floor really well. It's like a darker gray. It doesn't match with this gray very well, but we are going to be getting rid of this dresser, actually. We put it in here temporarily for the trip down to Houston, but since we're not doing that, then we're going to take it out. And the mini fridge is going to go here instead, and then the table is going to go here, and it's going to be really nice, and it's going to have more room. It's really nice to have some walking room in here, but yeah, I mean, we're getting pretty close here. I also went ahead and replaced all the interior lights with LED lights. They're not bright enough. I was hoping they were going to be super bright, but they're really not that bright. They'll save electricity and they won't kill the batteries as fast, but they're not bright, so that kind of sucks. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. Hopefully you like it. If you enjoyed, like. If you didn't enjoy, dislike. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. And yeah, I can't wait to take this thing on a trip. I'm really excited to go down to Florida once we finish the ARC 7. It's gonna be fun, but I think the next thing we're gonna do in here is either the front entranceway or this table. probably the front entrance way, because that thing, it needs some love. We're going to rip this all out and replace it with some wood planks and some nice trim and like exterior carpet stuff. You'll see. And then we're going to make a little shoe rack right there too, so it'll look really nice. Hey, you want to not be on your phone right now? So yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. So, peace out, and catch you next time. I'm in a bus. I'm in a school bus. I am in a school bus right now. This is a dope-ass school bus. Hell yeah.